Welcome to Water Wisdom, sponsored by waterfilters.net. I'm your host, Aquaman, and today I'm changing the filters in my Undersink point-of-use water filtration system. I have a Culligan SY2650 system. This system has two filter cartridges, a pre-filter and a post-filter. It's an electronically monitored system that measures the number of gallons that have actually gone through the system. Right here, there are a series of lights that alert me when I've reached the 400, 450, and 500 gallon mark. And then here is the reset button for the electronic monitor, which I'll touch in a moment when I've changed the filter cartridges. This is a very common system. There are many systems made by Culligan and other manufacturers that are very similar to this system that have two cartridges and supply a dedicated drinking water faucet. I've already turned off the water that supplies the system, and I've released the pressure by turning the drinking water faucet on until no water comes out any further. Now I'm ready to remove the cartridges. I have here my filter housing wrench, and I'm going to use this to unscrew the sumps from the filter unit itself. Lefty-loosey, righty-tighty, just like any normal screw. Now that I have it loose, I should be able to do the rest by hand. You notice I have a small bucket or vessel available right here next to me so that I can catch the excess water. There's a little bit of water that will come out. That's perfectly normal. Drain the water out. And then remove the cartridge. Now that I've removed the filter cartridge, it's time to take care of some housekeeping. I've rinsed out the inside of the filter sump and removed any crud that I found in the bottom. Sometimes old filters will leave carbon fines behind. I've cleaned those out, and now I'm going to take the handy-dandy butter knife and remove the O-ring for inspection and lubrication. It's very important that you take good care of your O-ring. It's the one thing that keeps your system from springing a leak and flooding your house in the middle of the night. So you feel it for abrasions, scrapes, nicks. Then we take food-grade silicone grease, just a small amount, and use that to lubricate the O-ring. Do not use petroleum-based products. Food-grade silicone grease is the only approved lubricant. Now that I've got that done, I'm going to replace the O-ring into the filter housing, seating it into the groove for the O-ring. And now, I'm going to replace the cartridge. The cartridges that I'm using are a very common set of cartridges called the P-250A from Pentec. The gray one is a granular activated carbon, and this one with the green end caps is a 0.5 micron carbon block. These are very high-end filters for this type of system. A very long list of contaminants are removed, including microorganisms, volatile organic compounds, lead, methyl tertiary butyl ether, which is a byproduct of fuel production, and many other things that you just plain don't want to drink. It really doesn't matter which filter cartridge goes in stage one. I have a personal preference of having the granular activated carbon in stage one, the first filter where the water enters the system. These filters are particular. They have to be inserted the proper end up. And you may not be able to see it here, but there's writing and an arrow on the side of the cartridge indicating the appropriate end up. So now that I know that, I'm going to insert the cartridge into my sump, making sure that it's seated properly on the bottom. Now I will reattach the sump to the filter unit. Righty-tighty, nice and easy. Notice that I'm not using the filter housing wrench. Hand tight only. The wrench is for removal only. Get a good grip, nice and tight, and we're good to go. Now, to remove the second filter housing. Got the tool handy. Now we'll unscrew it. And it's the same song, different verse. Drain the water. Old cruddy cartridge disposed of. And now, I'm going to clean out the sump and lubricate the O-ring. Now that I've cleaned out the sump and lubricated the O-ring and reinstalled it, I'll take my new cartridge and reinstall it into the sump. This cartridge, one end has a rubber gasket. That end must go up. So I'll install it that way. Seating it onto the little post in the bottom of the sump and then reattaching it to the filter system. Righty-tighty, just like before. And nice and easy. And then hand tight only. Get a good grip on it. And we're good. I will now go up above the sink and turn on the water faucet. Of course, turn on the water to the system. Turn on the water faucet and allow water to flow through the system for probably about 15 minutes before using it to flush the carbon filters before using the water. And there you have it, a complete point-of-use filter cartridge change on my Culligan SY2650 system. And there are many systems that are very similar to this with subtle differences that might make minor changes to the way that you perform the procedure. But basically, this is a simple dual cartridge point-of-use filtration system, and you can change these cartridges quite easily. I'm your host, Aquaman, and this has been Water Wisdom, sponsored by waterfilters.net. Thanks for watching.